All right, so A through D, let's go ahead and just start one at a time. Does A have a formal charge? No, it doesn't. It's fine. Does it have a partial charge? Actually, it does, okay? It doesn't have a double bond and it's not strained. Remember that I told you that the steric effects are usually just when you have like these small rings, so you don't really have to worry about it, okay? But A is going to be reactive because of the fact that it has a net dipole. So if I were to draw the dipole here, I would draw it towards the chlorine. That means I would have a negative and a positive, okay? And what that means is that this is going to be reactive because I have partial charges. Is that cool so far? Cool. We don't know how it's going to react, but we just know that it's reactive. Let's look at the second one. The second one was easy. It has a positive charge. That's a formal charge. So this one is definitely going to be reactive. Okay? Let's look at this next one. This next one has a ton of dipole moments. It actually has 4 dipole moments. So you would expect that this would be like super reactive, right? It's just going to like blow up, right? Actually, no. This turns out to be inert. Do you guys know what inert means? It means it doesn't react at all. It doesn't react with anything. And the reason is because it does not have a net dipole. Remember that you could have dipole moments, but if they're perfectly balanced, it's not going to create a net dipole. So in this case, this one actually would not react with anything because it does not have a net dipole. This is a tetrahedral, and it's perfectly balanced. All right? Then lastly, so I'm just going to put an X there, not reactive. And then the last one is a double bond. And remember that I said that double bonds are easy to break and they're good sources of electrons. So this one's also going to be reactive as well. So basically I had 3 reactive molecules, and I said 4, 3 reactive molecules in different ways, and then 1 unreactive molecule.